So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for updated information regarding the sessions and also about the courses. So let's move ahead to very first question, which says Central Athlete Injury Management System of the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Now, who is the Minister of Youth Affairs and Sports? Write down in the comments. Will start providing support to athletes for Dash and beyond. Alright, so you have to fill this gap. Now let's talk about this injury management system. So remember the Union Minister for Youth Affairs and Sports, jinka naam aapko comment mein likhke batana hai, has launched the Central Athlete Injury Management System. And this system, guys, has been launched for streamlining the sports medicine and rehabilitation facility, the support that will be offered to the athletes for Olympic 2024 and beyond. Olympic 2024 ke liye jo bhi medicine aur rehabilitation facilities provide karai ja rahi hai to the athletes, usko streamline karne ke liye, this injury management system has been launched. And this system aims to provide the best of sports injury management support nearest to the athlete's geographical location. Jo bhi athlete ka geographical location hoga, uske paas hi usko sari facilities provide karai jayengi. And remember, it is a first of its kind initiative by this ministry, and it will start providing support to the athletes who are a part of the TOPS scheme. Now, what is this TOPS? It's Target Olympic Podium Scheme. And there is a development group also, and to that development group under the top scheme, the support will be provided to the athletes to participate in the Olympics 2024 and beyond. Alright, get my point. So yahan pe kya hai? Basically, the support will be provided to that development group which is enrolled under the Target Olympic Podium Scheme for preparation of Olympic 2024 and beyond. Okay. And it will have four structures. This injury management system will have the four structures. Number one is athlete wellness cell. Then we have on field sports medicine experts, national resource referral teams, and number four, central core team. So these are the four structures of this injury management system. All right. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. So this is for Olympic 2024 and beyond. Olympic 2024 and beyond. And which brings me to one more question. Can you write down in the comments the location of Olympic 2024, where it will be held? Kahan pe hoga Olympic 2024? Ye aapko comment mein likh ke batana hai. And now let's move ahead to question number two. An MOU has been signed between NHPC Limited and Dash State Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited for implementation of Dagmara Hydroelectric Project. So guys, if you know where is this Dagmara Hydroelectric Project, then you can easily answer this question. Yes, you're absolutely right. It is in Bihar. And where in Bihar? It is in Supaul. Okay, there is a place in Bihar which is known as Supaul. So in Supaul, we have Dagmara Hydroelectric Project. And therefore, the correct answer should be what? Option B, Bihar. So with Bihar State Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited, NHP has signed an MOU for implementation of this hydroelectric project. And now let's talk more about this news. So remember, this project is located on the Kosi River, which is of course in Bihar, and it is a run of the river scheme. Now, what is the meaning of this run of the river scheme? Run of the river scheme ka matlab ye hota hai that this project, any project which is a run of the river scheme, use the downward flowing water of river. जो नीचे गिरता हुआ पानी है उसकी जो काइनेटिक एनर्जी है उसका इस्तेमाल करके जिस प्रोजेक्ट में किया जाता है, दैट इज नोन एज रन ऑफ द रिवर स्कीम. सो द रन ऑफ द स्कीम मींस व्हाट? द स्कीम, द प्रोजेक्ट वेयर डाउनवर्ड फ्लोइंग वाटर इट्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज यूज फॉर जनरेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ऑलराइट, नाउ द एनर्जी कैपेसिटी ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट गाइज इज हाउ मच? 130 मेगावाट. एंड द टोटल एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट इज हाउ मच? अराउंड 2500 करोड़, विच इज 2478.25 करोड़. ओके, so this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. Bihar is the correct answer, as I told you. And where in Bihar? Remember this, Dagmara Hydroelectric Project is in Supaul, which is of course in Bihar. Okay, and river also you should remember, it is being built on the river Kosi. And now let's move ahead to question number three. The defense minister has approved the budgetary support of 498.8 crores to Innovations for Defense Excellence, which in short is IDEX challenge, in June 2020. When was this initiative launched? ये कब ये लॉन्च कब हुआ गया था। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस IDEX। ये हम पहले भी पढ़ चुके हैं, IDEX के बारे में हमने पहले भी पढ़ा है। सो रिमेंबर दैट द बजटरी सपोर्ट ऑफ 498.8 करोड़ हैज बीन अप्रूव्ड फॉर दिस चैलेंज IDEX अंडर द डिफेंस इनोवेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स। अगले 5 साल के लिए अंडर द डिफेंस इनोवेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन IDEX को 498.8 करोड़ हैज बीन अलोकेटेड। ओके, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस DIO डिफेंस इनोवेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सो रिमेंबर गाइज इट इज सेक्शन 8 कंपनी अंडर द कंपनीज एक्ट ऑफ 2013 एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स फंडिंग एंड अदर सपोर्ट टू द कंपनीज विच आर प्रमोटिंग रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इन द डिफेंस सेक्टर, राइट। एंड दिस इनोवेशन फॉर डिफेंस एक्सीलेंस चैलेंज एम्स टू अचीव सेल्फ रिलायंस एंड फोस्टर इनोवेशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजी डेवलपमेंट इन डिफेंस एंड एरोस्पेस बाय एंगेजिंग इंडस्ट्रीज लाइक MSMEs, लाइक स्टार्टअप्स, लाइक इंडिविजुअल रिसर्चर्स, इंडिविजुअल डेवलपर्स, इनोवेटर्स एटसेट्रा। And talking more about this initiative, so remember it was launched in the year 2018 in the month of April, and it was launched to provide financial support to nearly 300 startups, MSMEs, individual innovators and 20 partner incubators under the DIO framework. This is funded and managed by Defence Innovation Organisation only, and it has partnered with leading incubators in the country to provide the handholding and other type of support to the winners of IDEX challenge. Okay, so this was about this news, and the correct answer should be what, guys? Option E, 2018, because the year, the launch year has been asked in the question. 2018 is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is, guys, a very very important question, because it is regarding the growth in agricultural export during the financial year 21, which was the last financial year. So the question is, what is correct about the growth? Now let's talk about the news first. So remember, the according to Commerce Ministry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, and he's also the Railway Minister, India's agriculture exports, including marine and plantation products. Remember this, export, agriculture export includes the marine and plantation products also. So this has been increased to $41.25 billion in the financial year 2021, which is an increase of 17.34%. as compared to the 2019-20. And if you talk about in the rupee terms, so there is an increase of 22.62%. And if you talk about, if we talk it, and agar hum isme amount ke baare mein baat kare, so from 2.49 lakh crores, it has been increased to how much rupees? 3.05 lakh crores, right? So in the terms of percentage, it has been increased by 22.62%, and from amount, it has been increased from 2.49 lakh crores to 3.05 lakh crores, right? So you have to remember this data. Ye data aapko yaad rakhna padega. This is very, very important. Now talking about this table, ab is table mein this row is important and this row is important. Other two row you can ignore. This is for agriculture export, including marine and plantation product, jo ki already humne padh liya. In terms of dollar, in the financial year 21, it was $41.25 billion. And if we compare it with the financial year 2019-20, it was $35.16 billion. So a percentage increase of how much? 17.34%. And balance of trade, you have to remember, $20.58 billion in the financial year 21. While in the financial year 20, it was $14.51 billion, which is an increase of 42.16%. Now, also remember the very important fact that the largest markets for India's agricultural export are the USA, China, Bangladesh. Just remember the top three: USA, China, Bangladesh. And after Bangladesh, we have more like UAE, Vietnam, Saudi Arabia, Indonesia, Nepal, Iran, and Malaysia. But you should remember only the top three: USA, China, and Bangladesh. And out of all these countries, the highest growth was recorded for Indonesia. That was 102.42%, more than 100%. Bangladesh 95.93% and Nepal 50.49%. So these are the top three highest growth जो कि कंट्रीज में हुए हैं एग्रीकल्चरल एक्सपोर्ट में. ओके, सो इस रिपोर्ट में आपको इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. इंडियाज एग्रीकल्चर एक्सपोर्ट इन यूएस डॉलर इंडिकेटिंग एन इंक्रीज ऑफ 17.34%. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड इंडियाज एग्रीकल्चरल एक्सपोर्ट इन रूपी टर्म्स इंडिकेट्स एन इंक्रीज ऑफ 22.62%. दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन सी, बोथ आर करेक्ट, शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. And now, guys, let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Ministry of Education, headed by Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, has released the guidelines for the development of e-content for children with disabilities. Children with disabilities के लिए जो e-content है उसके development के लिए guidelines को release किया गया है. So question is, which of the following will be the distribution platform and reading platform for this content respectively? Distribution platform कौन सा होगा और reading platform कौन सा होगा? So अगर आप इस न्यूज के बारे में पढ़ोगे भी नहीं ना, तब भी आप इसको इसका आंसर बहुत इजीली कर सकते हो अगर आपको थोड़ा बहुत भी नॉलेज है गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स का. बट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज फर्स्ट. सो द मिनिस्ट्री हैज अप्रूव द रिलीज ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ई कंटेंट फॉर द चिल्ड्रन विद डिसेबिलिटीज. एंड द गाइडलाइन सेज दैट द ई कंटेंट शुड बी बेस्ड ऑन द फोर प्रिंसिपल्स विच आर परसीवेबल, ऑपरेबल, अंडरस्टैंडेबल एंड रोबस्ट. सो दीज फोर क्वालिटीज शुड बी देयर इन द e-content which will be developed for the children with disabilities. Now the guidelines also says that the e-content should comply with the accessibility standards, the national standards and the international standards also. The distribution platform will be Diksha and the reading platform will be e-Pathshala, and all these platforms must comply with the technical standards also. And remember guys, one more thing yahan pe, that the distribution platform will not be only Diksha. There can be more distribution platforms also in future. And similarly for reading platform, there cannot be only this reading platform. There can be more reading platform in future. But currently, they have mentioned only these two platforms. For distribution, it is Diksha. For reading, it is e-Pathshala. All right. So, इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. And therefore, the correct answer should be what, option D, Diksha e-Pathshala, which means Diksha will be the distribution platform and e-Pathshala will be the reading platform. Okay. And that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.